journey through the 54 seconds, but do it in an experiential sense, in that I want you to connect to your body, okay? And feel them. Now, a small disclaimer. Your senses may be internal, or you may be experiencing them externally. For example, sense of movement. I can feel it internally, but also I can see it. Because none of these senses are isolated, they're all connected to each other. Okay? So, if we do this exercise, this will allow you to kind of experience the 54 senses, and then we can have another discussion afterwards. Because what you're going to find is, you're going to go, oh yeah, know that sense. Been using it a lot. Or you might find, that's a sense. What on earth is that? And it's these ones that we've kind of discounted, that we're not really sure of. So, is everybody here familiar, comfortable with going, closing eyes, and doing kind of guided meditation exercises?
Yes?
Cool. Awesome. So, I am going to read, because my sense of memory is not good enough to move all 50% of my head. I just want you to get really, really comfortable in your seats. Put both feet flat on the ground. Make sure that your bum is comfortable in the seat, because you're going to be sitting for about 15-20 minutes if you want to sit on the floor. If you want to lie down, you are also welcome to lie down. It's really important that you're comfortable in experiencing this. Okay? And remember, your senses are going to be in different states of activation and balance, and that is perfectly okay. So whatever experience you have is experience.
No wonder that girl.
I like it. I like this room. It's like, yeah, let's do coffee. Also, lie down. That's a very good, a sense is an experience, okay, an awareness, a sensation, okay, that is common throughout humans, and apparently, totally theoretical at this stage, of course, the earth and all of our living organisms, okay.
So like listening.
Pardon?
Just listening.
Just listening.
Yeah.
Is a sense.
Right, yeah, but the whole thing of what you're saying is just being more sensitive about how you're listening.
Exactly. It's realizing that you don't just listen with your ears. I mean, the concept of listening is that you're listening to what's not being said and tuning into all the subtle cues that if we are out in nature, we're used to. I mean, there are people, which I love, in the African desert, who have the ability to hear over a mile away. And that's freaking cruel. And it's realizing that we have really been constrained by how we're living to actually experience things in a far different way. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, it is this. And the more that we understand and explore and play these, the more that we can expand ourselves. And for me, there's a lot of talk about people saying, oh, we're becoming multi-sensory beings. And it all sounds really dramatic and, for me, a bit crazy. And I'm like, but multi-sensory? That means we're going in beyond our five senses and really realizing, oh, wow, this is how we could experience life in a way that's fully connected. And before we start this as well, it's important to remember that the planet, the Earth, there's always a constant pattern of rebalancing going on. And it's the same for us. Okay, so this is something that is continuing the whole time. So, again, get comfortable. Close your eyes. And take a deep breath in and out. And as we take another deep breath in, let's just acknowledge that even this breath is connected. The trees give us oxygen, and you, as you breathe out, symbiotic relationship that brings us to our first sense, your sense of hunger for air. Then focus on your sense of mind and consciousness. Become fully aware of my voice and how it feels to be sitting or lying. And just allow the awareness to build that you are right here, right now. And we activate your sense of relaxation and sleep. And pay attention to your brainwave state. Is the mind, that sense of mind, busy? Thoughts frantically rushing through the mind? Or are you moving into a different state of consciousness? Maybe into the alpha. Maybe lower. So on your next breath in through your nose, reactivate your sense of smell. And what smells do you notice in the air as you inhale? And does it smell different as you exhale? This time, breathe in through the mouth and reactivate your sense of taste. What does the air taste like as you breathe it in? And when you exhale it, is there a different taste to it? And just allow whatever thoughts, whatever feelings, whatever sensations to come up. Remember, there's no right, there's no wrong. This is just exploring and encountering more senses than normal. So reactivate your sense of feeling and touch. And bring your sense of mind and consciousness to the sensations of your feet, or your body, or how you're sitting on the floor. Then let's reactivate sense of weight and balance by just lifting one hand up and down and feeling the weight of that. You can do it a couple of times, just to get that sense of weight and balance. And as you're moving it, reactivate your sense of motion. And notice not just the weight, the balance, but the movement. Reactivate your sense of temperature and notice how warm or cold the air feels around your bare skin and how there is a contrast in temperature between the parts of your body that are covered. Reactivate your sense of pressure and notice the air as it moves around your body. Is there any changes as you bring that sense of consciousness and awareness to the air and how it feels against your body? Now, open your eyes and reactivate your sense of sight and light. surroundings. You don't need to focus on anything in particular. Just allow that awareness of light to come in. And then reactivate your sense of proximity, your sense of space. How does it feel to be in this room? Next to people, separate from people. How does that proximity feel? And reactivate your sense of colour. And notice the different colours as they come in through the sense of light. If you focus on one colour that catches your eye, reactivate your sense of mood and identity. What does this colour mean to you? If you're more comfortable, you can go back to closing your eyes if that's helpful for you. And if you want to go on a deeper journey, you can bring up a sense of memory of a time that you've been out in nature, a time that you have felt connected, alive, rejuvenated. Take a moment to actually bring that memory forth and use the senses that we've already talked about. The sense of space, the sense of colour, the sense of mood, the sense of pressure and temperature. What are you noticing in this memory? And as you're there, reactivate your sense of radiation, which allows you to see or sense non-visible light. And maybe think of a time that you'd be able to sense that radiation. Maybe in a city, or maybe in nature. Bring your sense of mind to your body. And as we do this, know that you are safe and you're supported by nature. Reactivate your sense of pain briefly. Become aware of anything painful in your life right now. And this is nature's way of saying, this is not connected to me. Reactivate your sense of physical place with an awareness of the land around you. Maybe that's the land within the memory. Maybe it's a sense of place to where you are now in this room. Remember, there's no right, there's no wrong, whatever experience that you're having. It's giving you an understanding and explanation of all these senses. The next time that you breathe out, reactivate your sense of humidity. Become aware of any water in the air. And notice, does the air feel dry? Moist? Reactivate your sense of weather changes, either in your memory, even today with a reflection of how the weather has changed throughout today. And whatever memory you have in your mind just now, reactivate your sense of form and design. Look at our nature. What long days, early mornings, so much light. And take a moment to contrast it. How do you feel in winter, especially with such opposites? Reactivate your sense of emotional place, community, belonging. Even within nature or within this room, you're part of a community, a sense of belonging. Reactivate your cultural sense that allows you to cultivate crops in a way that connects you to the earth. Reactivate your sense to hunt or gather food, to eat in harmony with the earth. And reactivate your aesthetic sense and observe the beauty in whatever image is within your mind just now. In whatever moment you are experiencing, reactivate your sense of pleasure and laughter, along with the humor. Really feel that joy. But when you're out in nature, that sense of freedom and aliveness, allow that sense to build. Bring your sense of awareness back into your body and reactivate your hormonal sense. For some of you, that might mean the awareness of a cycle that changes, a cycle that no longer changes, or for the men, a cycle that is steady and stable. And as you activate this sense, feel how it impacts on your urge for procreation, your sense of procreation. And then reactivate your sense of self. How does it feel right now as you move through this exercise? Allow whatever thoughts, feelings, sensations to come up. There's no right, there's no wrong. Reactivate your sense of psychic capacity and sense life forces of the natural world that on an energetic level they're all connected. Trees, the animals, the plants, the water, the sea, Norfolk law. And reactivate your sense of electromagnetic fields. See if you can play with the energy that you feel from life forces. If you struggle with this, there's an electromagnetic frequency field that emanates from your heart. It shows that it extends up to 5 feet surrounding your body. Can you feel that? Feel this energy. Whether from your heart, whether from nature, surrounding you. And reactivate your sense of pupation, the sense of being able to go, to curl up, cocoon yourself. The energy that precedes transformation. As you're safe, in the sense of a cocoon. Reactivate your sense of fear. And know that this is nothing more than a sign to reconnect. And let the awareness of this draw you back into whatever memory of nature. There's no memory, the sound of the birds outside. The sense of hearing. They twitter and tweet and have done. Bring your awareness back to your sense of self and see if you can feel the energy of the self dissolving as you invite the energy of nature in. Reactivate, become aware of your sense of stress and surrender as you allow the tension. Allow yourself to expand. Allow the energy of nature in, the everything and the nothing in the entire universe. See if you can feel any of this energy move throughout you. Reactivate your electromagnetic sense. You can feel the power move through your body, the nervous system, and the brain. And go deeper. Reactivate your sense of spirituality. Let love and ecstasy fill your being. Go deeper into that love and ecstasy. Reactivate your sense of unity and enter fully into the nature of everything and nothing, of oneness. Play with how this feels. And allow yourself to move away from a sense of unity. Reactivate your sense of mental and spiritual distress. Know that that's just nature calling you back. Say, come back. Come home. Reactivate your sense of humility and appreciation as you experience this connection, this sense of being connected to something more. Reactivate your sense of language and articulation and find one word that summarizes this experience up for you. Reactivate your sense of intuition and see what comes up as through this interplay with nature. If there's any guidance, any words of wisdom. Reactivate your sense of reason and memory to anchor in this moment the word, any intuitive information that arose. And then reactivate your sense of astral time, your ability to travel to the past, the present, and the future. And see if nature will offer you a gift. And just allow whatever experience you're having to come up. Knowing that you've safe. Reactivate your sense of gravity and really feel the pull connecting you down to the earth, down to the floor. And then see if it's possible through this connection to feel the wisdom of the earth. 4.6 billion year old living organism, expert in balance, in growth, in transformation. Reactivate your sense of survival through joining into a larger organism. Recognize that you're more than just a human being. You're an earth being. And reactivate your sense of awareness of the rotation of the earth as it spins and dances throughout the universe. As we now know that even as we sit in this room, the earth is spinning, dancing, twirling throughout the universe at a rate of 77,000 kilometers per second. Yet we feel stillness. Reactivate your sense of territory. Know that this is home. Reactivate your sense of connection to all living beings on earth. And invite a sense of compassion for all of them into your awareness. Reactivate your sense of charisma and feel presence and the energy of attraction, of magnetism, fill your body. Reactivate your sense of excretion. Feel the desire to let go of any waste that stops you from connecting to nature. Any of the crap, the nonsense that is not part of you. You as the earth, it's not part of the earth. Reactivate your sense of hearing and become aware of the sounds, the cars as they're driving around outside. No birds anymore. And reactivate your sense of awareness of your own visibility or invisibility as you stand, sit or lie in your body. Coming back to being fully present. And reactivate your sense of time and rhythm. Let it match the ebb and flow of your breath. As you again take some deep breaths in and out. And lastly, focus again on your sense of relaxation and sleep. Pay attention to that brainwave state. So if you observe your sense of mind, just allow yourself to think and observe, where are you now? Is there a shift in your brainwave state? And just give yourself a few moments to come back, to reground.
need to stretch, move the body. Whatever you need to do to get. Is it giving you a deeper understanding of just how limited we're actually experiencing the world? How there is so